April 2013. Welcome to the month's news from Angling Lines. Coming up in our special.
I've got a problem in some ways with tight line.
I'm sorry, Ron, but I can't agree with you fully on that.
First, a roundup of the month's news. Holly Pools has some of its smaller cats and carp removed from the main lake. Swims 2 and 3 get a refurb at Waters Meet. And there's now an additional swim in front of the mobile home at Commons. Fishing news, and we start at Rozzo, where this 60-pound big head surprised everyone. It's never been out before. Sapphire angler Austin Reed makes a double lake record with this 53-pound 10-ounce mirror. At Commons, the lake record falls twice in April with the two latest 50-pound Commons. April sees a double at Molyneux too, with two new lake records for carp and cats. And Mehdi's Larussi has a brand new 60. Mehdi says it's called Le Grand Mâle, the big male. It's the biggest male in the lake. Last summer, in our How to Catch Carp in France series, we featured both slack lines and tight line techniques. Here, old fishing pals Ron Key and Ken Dallow take sides. First though, the all-important question of what line each angler is using.
The line that I use for nearly all of my fishing is P-line extrusion. The 15-pound rated line is 0.3. It's very, very supple. It's good abrasion resistance, great knot strength, and it'll really take the hammer of the casts.
And then 16-pound P-line, which is a very thin line but very high strength. It's one of the thinnest 16-pound lines that you'll find, and it's got very little stretch.
I'm fishing at about 110 yards. I'm casting to the edge of the tree line with the weight of the line balanced against the bobbins with no stretch at all in the line to increase the level of indication.
Being an elderly gentleman and a long-time member of the Rinkley Club, I'm unable to cast all that far these days with having a dicky back. So I've decided on here to use a bait boat.
I tend to fish with fairly slack lines, and that's for a couple of reasons. If I'm fishing a shallow water in particular, I like the lines to be low in the water and keep as much of the line on the bottom as I possibly can. The other reason that I like to do it is because of indication. What I tend to do is pay off the line gradually once I've cast and put the rod and the rest, let it sink, pay off a little bit more, let it sink until I've got a situation whereby I can clip on the bobbin and I can actually balance the weight of the bobbin against the weight of the line. I try to reach a state where there's no stretch in the line at all. And then if I get any movement at all at the fish end, any movement goes directly to the bobbin. And for that reason, I think that slack lines give better indication than tight lines.
Well, I'm sorry, Ron, but I can't agree with you fully on that. I like to be in direct contact with my hook, so I tend to fish tight lines with a back lead, usually about 10 feet out from the tip of the rod. So the line follows the bottom, just the same as yours does, but as soon as a fish picks that bait up, I get a beep. And it's like the other morning when I had that first 40, I had two beeps, got to the rod, saw a slow lift, and struck and got it. And the fish I had yesterday morning was at 140 yards with a line all the way along the bottom with a back lead 10 feet from the end of the rod. And I got an immediate indication when that fish picked the bait up.
I got exactly the same, and two of the fish that I've caught this week I've caught on single beeps. And I've got the slightest indication. I mean, the fish only moved that bobbin perhaps a quarter of an inch and moved the leader, you know, just a few inches, and I got a lift, immediately got a lift. There was no stretching the line to take up or anything. The bobbin just went straight up.
I know you've had eight or nine fish, but I have had 240s.
How many did you miss?
Do you know, in 41 years of carp fishing, I've never seen a budgie on my rod before.